kuna timu mosi nija wotkara chuonyo James Onyango Tieno James ati muni mosi makende mama jadida ati muni mosi akendo mosi aijaru wakutuketu wito uwenye I observe all protocol. To kapo kabi nime. Kapo kabi nime. Adwaro munda appreciate in totality our Jensen. Jensen still and the students from Jekwat. Kumane Woodwanity. I want to tell you that I'm really appreciative of what you have done. We are very proud of you. You have made us very proud of what we are seeing today. You are part of the very cause. You are part of the very cause of justice that we want in Kenya. When you came here, you started by singing the national anthem of Kenya, where you were saying, justice, justice shall be my shield and defender. And when you are advancing the reasons for what's going on today, you are doing it because you want justice in Kenya. You are doing it because you want peace in Kenya. You have done it in a totally different style, a style that we have never seen before. One thing I don't understand about you is that you cannot communicate with 1 million people when those sitting next to you do not know. It is a unique thing. And what we see as Kenyans is the result of that communication. I'm a member of parliament, and I was amazed by the crowd that was facing Bunge without Kenyans knowing that you are that many. I know we gave you education, we paid your fees, we gave you scholarship. We gave you bursary. You got your education, but we didn't know that the result of this can be of that magnitude we are seeing today. With those words, you know I'm supporting your cause. And I'm telling you that if you keep on this, with peace, crowning everything you are doing, Kenya will be a different country. Recently, during our mourning of our departed son, the young people were lighting candle in the quarters of Karachuonyo, a candle to mourn themselves. I was part of them, and I told the Karachuonyo people that I know these themselves people from what I've been seeing. They are peaceful, and you are going to see that they do this thing very peacefully and nothing will go wrong. Thanks to those who are there, you did it peacefully and nothing went wrong. Now, I know when the COSA students were here, our students, the Karachuonyo constituency, Students Association, when they were here, they made a request to me. They made a request to me through their chairman, Edwin. And Edwin, I want you to listen to this. I have agreed with your request. And I want themselves parents to listen to this. I want Kanjira people to listen to this. I consulted with the headmaster of one of the schools immediately after the students had given their speech. I consulted with the headmaster of the school, which is closest to where we are, and that's Adiro Primary School. So I've agreed that I'm going to build one classroom for them, and we are going to name it. We are going to name it. You know the name? Now the name is going to be Denzel Omondi Onyango Classroom. We are doing this to honor the young man we are burying today. I don't want to say much because what you asked me to do, I've done. And again, what the Gen Z in Karachuonyo asked me to do, I think I did that. Having said this, I think where is Kabasa? Okay, you will give me just a minute. Wafula book is here. I just wanted to give him a second to greet the people, after which I go to the final part. Can he come? Wafula is not there. If you can just say a word before you.
Well, Wakenya wenzangu na wasalamia mjambo. I have 1 minute and I'll stick to that. You see, many have died in the struggle, and I wanted just one to speak to you today in this brief minute. It's Steve Biko. He said, it is better to die fighting for what we live than to live fighting for what will die. Nenzo, his ideas will live on and inspire many. I want to tell you this, there are many people who do not know fully who killed Danson. Of course, the first one is obvious, the state. But who next? Denzel checked, saw the suffering of his age mates. Some can't marry, can't eat 3 meals, and said, I can do something about it. For that alone, for your suffering, he got inspired to stand up and die. The third murderer is those of us who have been in the struggle. He read books by Nelson Mandela, our own Raila Odinga, people in the struggle like young Babu, and he said, I can do the same. So he decided to act, and there we are. We got into problems, and he died. So friends, General Z, I say sorry for the suffering, the family, Paul, the struggle continues. I used to be called chairman, and now you are called president. It's because of a struggle. There's only more you could be called president that time. I was the chairman of SONU for a very short time. Babu takes the record as having led for 4 years, only led for 9 days, because of the tough times. You see, I think that we are on the right track. The advice I give the Generation Z is please take charge. Don't allow us to lead you. You're doing it effectively. We tried and failed. You tried and succeeded. Don't hand over leadership to us. Thank you.
And in ending, let me say that I condemn those who are responsible for the death of Jensel. I condemn that on behalf of Karachuonyo. Let me say that we want to know how Jensel ended dying because he must have been abducted. Who abducted him and how did he die? All these are deaths we expect from the authority. The government must tell us that. We need to know. As I end, I say, the Gen Z's, we appreciate what you have done. Continue. We are with you. And do it effectively in peace that you have been doing it. Now, I think finally, I want to call my colleagues, and I'm going to ask him to do a smaller round so that we can leave something here. I know he had done something. Let me not fail to say that. He gave us a good amount. Probably you want to announce it yourself later. It was in the ward. I also did the same. Since I'm going to ask you to do a rambe, you will announce those two, yours and mine, and those which are not in the ward, let me announce them because you didn't see them. One was by Babu, Owino Gutshit, the MP for Newa. He gave me 20,000 shillings, which I had already, given. And then I have also got 20,000 shillings from the minority leader, Opio Wandayi. I think the other one, you didn't tell me, you told me our governor gave some contribution, but you didn't tell me the amount. Can you tell me so that I... You were telling me to announce. Okay. With that one,